Give the heading, target costing. Please. Target costing. We are going to have an introduction, little bit fairly long introduction. Please. Once the introduction is over, chapter is completed. That's all, okay. Nothing more. In all the sums, we'll write the introduction again and again. Understood? All problems in target costing, story is same only. Only the problem what? Changes. Once we discuss one problem, the same is what? All the other sums only. The format is going to change, not the concept. Okay, please. Now, I have to complete the introduction, do at least two sums in target costing. Please, can I start or not? Now, let's start with the target costing chapter. This is a chapter very much relating to the pricing chapter. Relating to the pricing chapter. We have something called as cost plus pricing. Something called as what? Cost plus pricing. Where we know that selling price is fixed as cost plus what? Profit. Please. Selling price is equal to cost plus profit. How a company fixes selling price? It calculates the cost of manufacturing and selling its product, and to that cost it adds what? Some margin which it wants based on the return on capital employed. We saw a number of sums in pricing, right or not? Now, and the cost plus profit gives you the selling price. That is how selling price is fixed. Normally it is called as cost plus pricing. Everybody understood or not? Now, this cost plus pricing is okay if the market is monopolistic or maximum what? Oligopoly. Understood? It can be either monopoly or oligopoly, where few players or you are the dominant player, whatever you fix the selling price, they'll be what? Accepting it. And the commodity is also a necessity, not a luxury goods. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? Now, in such case, this system of selling price is equal to cost plus profit will work very much. Everybody following or not? Now, suppose the market is competitive. Market is what? Competitive. Competition is not only from local players, there are also multinationals, companies from all over the globe now can compete in any country, right or not? Indian cars are getting sold in what? Europe also, Tatas and all. Like that, European companies as well as what? American are selling the cars in what? India. All have their branches, subsidiaries, ventures, etc. And now the market has become what? Global. Where competition for any product is cutthroat. Are you following what I am saying? In that case, selling price is not fixed by the company. It is fixed by what? Customers. Okay. Company loses the right to fix what? Selling price. The selling price is fixed by what? The ultimate customers. Will it be falling on? Now, let us see what happens when I continue with this cost plus pricing. Okay. Now, my company is following a cost plus pricing and then fixing a selling price. Okay. Now, tell me, if my selling price is higher, a new company comes in, a new competitor enters. If I am selling at 100, he is coming for what? 90. What selling price is here? 90. Tell me, what happens to my demand? What my demand was? The demand decreases. If my selling price is high, the demand what? Decreases. It leads to decrease in demand. Everybody, yes or no? Now, when my demand decreases, what happens to my cost? When my demand decreases, the per unit cost what? Increases. Because most of the fixed costs are now going to be recovered through what? Fewer number of units. So what happens is, the cost per unit what? Increases. Increase in cost per unit. Response is on what? Now, when the cost per unit increases, profit margin is on what? Cost. My profit margin also what? Increases. Increase in what? Profit margin. Which once again increases what? My selling price. Which further what? Triggers down the demand. Again what? Cost further increases. Then what happens? Selling price further increases. This becomes a vicious cycle. Everybody following or not? Now, after some time, what happens is my product will be pushed out of the market due to the lack of demand. My market share will be gone. I am going to be a redundant player in the market. Respond, yes or no? Now, the problem is due to cost plus pricing. The problem is what due to cost plus pricing, because this cost plus pricing never makes me adapt to the change, as the cost plus pricing forces me further to what? Increase selling price. When the demand drops, I should have reduced my price, but the system what? Makes me increase the price, which further aggravates the problem, and this is a wrong system of pricing, is what we are seeing in the first discussion. Everybody following or not? No. Tell me, cost plus pricing is a good system or bad system? Bad system in case of what? Competitive market. If my price is higher, my demand drops. My demand drops, the per unit cost increases, which further increases my selling price, a profit and selling price, which further triggers what? Demand drop and so on. It is, instead of solving the problem, is aggravating what? Problem very much, and the product will be pushed out of the market after some time. Is a disadvantage of the cost plus pricing. Yes or no? No. What they said is, this cost plus pricing is wrong. It is what? Wrong. Please change the equation. The equation is, cost is equal to selling price minus profit. Instead of saying selling price equal to what? Cost plus profit. Cost is equal to what? Selling price minus profit. You may wonder, sir, only left hand side, right hand side what? Rearrange. What is so great you are saying? Yes or no? No. Just selling price is equal to what? Cost plus profit. So cost is equal to what? Selling price minus profit. You change the equation. What happened? We have not changed the equation. You have changed the attitude. We change what? Attitude. You are not changing a formula. We are changing what? Attitude of the management towards the pricing policy. Everybody following or not? No. What is this attitude? This is what I give the name called as what? Target costing. We give the name called as what? Target costing. Now, what is the difference between this formula? Both are same formula only, but why my perception changes. What changes here? My perception changes. Here I feel that I am fixing selling price. And cost is not in my control. I am paying cost. Somebody fixes what? My purchase price. Cost is not in my control. What is in my control is what? Selling price. So the feeling is I am fixing selling price. The decision is selling price fixation. Right or not? Here I recognize that I am not fixing selling price. Market what? Determine selling price. This is not the price fixed by me. The price determined by what? Market. From the market price, reduce the margin you want. In this cost, I should try to manufacture and sell. Here I feel that selling price is uncontrollable. Cost is what? Controllable. Here I feel that selling price is in my control. Cost is not in what? My control. So the entire attitude has what a change that led to a revolution in what the pricing called as what? Target costing. Everybody, yes or no? No. So now tell me, what is the formula? Cost is equal to selling price minus profit. To be much more particular, what? Target cost is equal to what? Selling price minus profit. See, what is the market going selling price for this product? Take the price, reduce what? The margin what you want. The balance should be what? The cost that we use for manufacturing and selling it. Suppose in the market, the product is selling at 90 rupees. For my capital, I want an 8 rupees profit. I should be having how much cost? I should try to manufacture and sell. How much rupees here? 82 rupees is what we call target costing. Point number one. Are you following or not? Yes, sir. So two issues discussed. What is the disadvantage of cost plus pricing? And what do you mean by a target costing? Can I further continue with the discussion or not? No. The question is, company is at present, say the, I'll just go it here. Okay. So the market price is how much rupees? 90. So market price how much rupees? 90. I want the profit how much rupees? 8. What should be the target cost? 82. Suppose currently my current cost is suppose 88 rupees. What is the current cost here? 88 rupees. I am manufacturing and selling out how much rupees? 88 rupees. But my target cost is what? 82 rupees. That means I should do something to reduce my cost from 88 to 82. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You know, sir, how can I reduce my cost? Is it possible? The reason is, selling price I can fix. Right? Yes, I cannot fix my purchase price. My supplier fixes. Right?
Yes,
I cannot fix my wages because the employees demand based on market rate. I cannot determine my power cost because power is determined by what? Government. I cannot fix the fixed asset cost because the supplier fixes all this. I'm buying from some other person. I don't have the legal right. I'm only obeying what they're fixing. How can you say cost is controllable? It is better to increase the price. How can I go for what? Cost reduction when all are fixed by outsiders. In a paradigm. The question is, how can I reduce an 88 rupees cost to what 82, where none of the cost is in my control, because I don't fix my material price, the other party fixes. I don't fix my power cost, the government fixes. I don't fix the factory rent, the landowner fixes. I don't fix the wages. What happens? The market, the what is the labor market, what fixes and so on, they have their own expectation. Then how can I say that 88 can be reduced to what 82? How it can be done is the next issue. Are you following what I'm saying? For this only, the company embarks upon a program called as cost reduction program. What program? Cost reduction program, which is zero base, which is what? Zero base. The word zero base means I don't look into past. I look afresh everything regarding cost. Everybody follow and say, I don't go by the pattern or past trends. What happened in past is what? Past. I want to have a relook afresh into every angle. I go for a zero base analysis of cost and try to go for a cost reduction by going for a program called as what? Cost reduction program. Everybody following that? This cost reduction program consists of a very important activity called as value engineering. What activity called as what? Value engineering. Okay, so the company starts a process called as what? Value engineering process. What is the value engineering process? Is a process in which every cost I'll closely watch and see whether this cost is needed or not needed. Is it value adding cost or non-value adding cost? So I classify the entire cost which the company is spending into two categories. One category is value added cost, and then what? Non-value added cost. If I weed out the non-value added cost, the cost can be what? Reduced. This process we call as what? A value engineering process. Are you following what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now the question is, so how we can know whether a cost is value added, non-value added? What happens in a real company in this process called as what? Value engineering. Okay. This value engineering can be further divided into two processes. One is called as design engineering, another is called as process engineering. What are two processes here? Design engineering and then what? Process engineering. Okay, see. Let's start with the first item called as what? Design engineering. Okay, now I am manufacturing a product. Okay, what is a product? Product is bundle of features. Any product is what? Bundle of features. You take a table. Table is nothing but what? A bundle of features. It is having a feature rack. Things can be kept on it. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It can have a drawer where things can be what? Kept inside it. Yes or no?
Yes,
it can have what? A provision for keeping what? A mic. This table is having what? A provision for keeping a mic. It is having what? An electronic system that is able to want a support and audio for the entire classroom. Yes or no? Now, this table and that table are different because it is having a different feature. That's having what? Different features. Does not have a mic facility. It is having what? Mic facility. So that means this table is a product. What is this product? It consists of so many features. So simply to put it, a product is nothing but bundle of features. What a product here? Bundle of features. Respond yes or no? Okay. Now, any product features can be classified into two types. One is called as functional features. Another is called as aesthetic features. What two features are? Functional features and then what? Aesthetic features. Are two features of a product. Functional and then what? Aesthetic features. Functional feature is necessary to perform the function of the product. Respond. Are you learning? See, for example, there's a fridge. That is what? A refrigerator. Okay. In a refrigerator, there's something called as compressor.
Yes, sir.
The compressor creates what? Chillness. Okay. Now, I say, compressor is too costly. Let me remove the feature from what? Refrigerator. I remove it, save the cost. What happens here? It becomes a bureau.
Yes, sir.
It cannot cool. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, in that case, the compressor is a functional feature that defines a product. Yes or no? I'm manufacturing a car, yeah? Brake is too costly. Let me remove brake from the car and manufacture and reduce the car price. Can you do it or not? Ratko, wrong answer here, please. In that case, those features which add to the functionality of the product is called as what feature here? Functional features. Those features are always value added. It's always what? Value added. That defines a product. Respond. Yes or no? A car cannot be without a tire. A car can't be what? Without a brake. Cannot be without a steering. Without an engine. All these are what? Defining that particular product usage itself. It is going to define the utility of the product. That should be always that. It is called as what? Value added. Functional features. Yes or no?
No.
aesthetic features are those features that adds appeal, that adds what? Appeal to the product or adds some extra comfort to the product. Respond. Are you following now? Now, please. This aesthetic feature can be classified as value added or non-value added. Whatever aesthetic feature for which the customer is willing to pay money, for which what? Is willing to pay money, he wants it compulsorily, that is called as what? Value added. And aesthetic feature which if he has, he is happy. If he does not have, he is not unhappy. But if you charge for that, it becomes what? Unhappy means that becomes what? Non-value added. Everybody following now? I'll give a simple example. We have a car, okay. Car la paint is done or not? The car painting done or not? No. Paint is necessary for the car. Okay, paint is too costly. Yes or no? If I take insurance on paint gone, it's yes or no? In that case, paint is too costly. So company says, I'll sell unpainted car. I'll sell what? Unpainted car. Will anybody buy it? This aesthetic feature only, but people want require it. When scratch, they go and paint once again. Yes or no? In that case, that feature is one feature. Aesthetic feature, value added, customer wants it. Are you following what I'm saying? Yeah, put it in. Suppose in a car, okay, in a car, life saving system is there. In Benz and all, we have a life saving system, airbag, etc. Okay, now tell me, for that airbag, I want to charge something around 20 lakh rupees extra. Will a person pay it? Only niche market, less persons want to pay it. In such case, that feature, father, you are not willing to pay, it is there, okay. Not there means, I don't want to pay 1.5 crores for a car, which gives me so much safety, because anyhow, my safety is the God's hand, yes or no? Correct what I am saying? In that case, please. In such a case, I will not be willing to what? Pay money for that particular feature. That's called as one feature, non-value added aesthetic feature. Respond, yes or no? No. So there are two types of features, functional features, aesthetic features. Functional features are always what? Value added. That define the utility of the product itself. Yes or no? Aesthetic adds appeal, gives some extra benefits, which can be value added if the customer wants it compulsorily, can be what? Non-value added if the customer is okay without it. Everybody is or no? No. Why I'm doing so is, if I remove some features from the product, if I remove what? Some features from the product, what happens is, activities required to have those features can be avoided. Yes, sir. Correct? No. Suppose I want to remove, say a GPS system from what? A car. Okay, I want to remove a feature. Now it has become necessity. Earliness is not what? Necessity. I want to remove a feature from the car. What happens is, whatever activity, manufacturing activity, I'm just having for that feature can be avoided or not? When I avoid an activity, the activity-based cost can be saved. Whatever cost incurred for the activity can be what? Saved. So when a feature is avoided, activities relating to the feature can be what? Avoided. When activities are avoided, activity based cost can be what? Saved. Now the question is, sir, when I remove this feature, how much cost is saved? Question is no. Father, we should be having an activity based costing system. Yes or no? That is, when I remove a feature, I remove this feature from this product. So those activities are what? Avoided. How much cost is it? If I ask a management accountant, you should be able to tell me the answer or not. Yes, so he should be having what? An ABC system in place. Target costing is not possible without what? A company having an activity-based costing system. How the system works, we'll see in the next chapter. Everybody follow what I'm saying? That's why we put both the chapters what? Together. Target costing and then what? ABC costing. One of the important uses of ABC costing is what? In supporting a target costing system. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? No. This is point number one. Tell me, why I'm doing all this? To reduce my cost. Because I cannot increase my selling price, I'd only become what? More efficient to reduce my cost. How a cost can be reduced? By going for a cost reduction program. What a cost reduction program? It goes for a process called as value engineering. I've got how many aspects? Two aspects. Design engineering, process engineering. What is the design of a product? Bundle of features, which can be functional, which can be aesthetic. Functional is always value added. Aesthetic is value added. The customer is what? Willing to pay money, and normal is going to be okay without it. Everybody is on no. Now, I have finalized my product features. This should be my product. I finalized my design. Yes, what is design? A feature of a product. This should be the product that has been what? Finalized. Removing all the non-value added. Yes or no? No. Next is, I go for the process of manufacturing and what? Selling. Without our knowledge, the company will be unnecessarily engaged in some activities. Yes, one simple example is metal handling. I'll give a simple example. I am manufacturing a product. which undergoes two processes. Process one is in next building. Process two in what? This building. What happens? The building in factory will be far away. Yes or no? The factory will be in acres of land. Yes or no? What I'm saying? No. In that case, that building machine produces, I should use a transporting system to transport to what? Next building, and then do it. It's called metal handling. Yes or no? This work is a waste. In a transporting does not add any value to product. Yes, had a properly structured my factory load where I can have small machines where your product can be manufactured in what? Same building, and avoid the metal handling or not? Yes, we saw this in machine cells just in time. Right or not? Yes, that is a process improvement. Yes, they're going to be called as what? A process improvement. Like that. So many process. I showed you on that day that example of Maruti Suzuki where instead of turning and what? Taking the tools and then fitting the assembly. If they have it in what? Built. What happens? It becomes a time saved. Lot of cost. I said around 300 crores has been what? Saved. In that particular case. Any right or not? That is also what? A process improvement. Small improvement. Always they should go for what? Process. It's called as process engineering. What is process engineering? Analyzing the process thoroughly. See what the process is happening. In that, you weed out what? Non-value-added process and keep only what? Value-added process. By eliminating non-value-added process or activity, I say what? Those activity-based costs, that results in what? Cost saving. For that also, I should know what? The ABC system. In a paridamal. That means ABC system is what? Integral part of the target costing system. Can I proceed or not? No. So this is where the company is engaged in time and motion study, work study, etc., where they closely monitor with stopwatches and all how the workers are performing. Unnecessary movements can be what? Avoided. Unnecessary transportation of goods. Even when you have there can be different ways of manufacturing. Circular way of what? Manufacturing goods where it will be moving in what? Circular motion where the components are fit in and then what? Comes back. Sometime maybe what? Up and down. So some products it may be better. Some products what? Other may be better. Economy in movements. Economy in what? Metal handling. Economy in scrap, etc. should be what? Seen. It's called as what improvement? Process improvement. Through that cost can be saved. Everybody so know now. And this is a continuous process. Don't think that this time I finalize a process, it's not the best. Next time it can be what? Much more better. Always workers are encouraged to give ideas to improve on process, which they call as Kaizen approach. They call us what approach? Kaizen approach. It's nothing but the process of continuous improvement. Improvement will be very small improvement. It adds to what? A big cost savings for the company. Respond, are you following what I'm saying? No. This is what we call as a process engineering. With all this, I can try to reduce my cost. Everybody following or not? No. So, I want to reduce my cost from 88 to what? 82. I did the design engineering. I did what? Process engineering. I managed to reduce my cost from 88 to 84. How much of it is here? 84. Everything what I could have what? Done it. So the cost reduced from 88 to 84. I could not reduce to what? 82. For the 2 rupees can increase the selling price. No. See, for me to have a 90 rupees, 8 rupees profit, my cost is what? 84. Can I sell at 92 rupees or not? No. Because never should I touch what? The market price. What next I should do is, after doing the value engineering, still if I could not achieve what? Target cost. The next step is what? Compromise on margin. Compromise on what? Margin. Even after compromise on margin, if you're not able to achieve what? Target cost. Next step is what? Increase price up. No, you come out of the market. If you don't come out of the market, you will be pushed out. Are you following what I'm saying? Which is better, coming out or pushing out? Coming out, na, I can book profit and come out. That's not. Pushing out means what? I'll be incurring what? Losses again and again. Whatever again will be what? Loss. And then I'll come out. Everybody, yes or no? Are you following? This is what you call as what system? Target costing system. This is a continuous process every company should be undertaking year after year. You know, are you following what I'm saying? Because in competitive marketplace, now this has become the norm. Rarely in bidding industries, in natural resources, cost plus pricing may be what? Adopted. But mainly in consumer goods and other areas, electronic goods, it is only what that is prevailing? Target costing system where selling price is market determined and I have the control only over the cost. Have a relook into the entire system, try to improve efficiency and reduce the cost is the motto of this particular target costing. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Yes, with this, target costing chapter is over. Okay, it is what? Over. All the sums, question will be asked with the numbers. With the numbers, I'll be giving what? The same answer again and again. So I will not give, repeat this for all the sums. If I tell for one sum, the same answer should be done for what? All the sums. We'll only do the calculations and nothing what more in that. Enna paapurindha?
No.
In the workbook, we'll have a first basic problem to understand the target costing system. One problem for design engineering, one problem for what? Value engineering. And all the three sums are from Hongren only. And these sums are hit problems, can be asked in the examination anytime. Everybody can understand or not? And ABC and target costing, that is also important part. I am not discussing in that part. I have a separate section C in the chapter dealing with what? ABC and target cost system, which we will do after completing the activity based costing chapter. Everybody understanding it or not?
No.
I am not going to dictate notes. I'll dictate notes along with the problem. Can you understand or not?
Now,
before that, I just want to have the flow and then start. Once flow is set, problem chapter is over. Okay, tell me first. The traditional way of pricing is what pricing? Cost plus pricing. What is selling price?
Cost plus profit.
What is selling price here?
Cost plus profit.
This system is good in case of what? Monopoly, etc. In competitive, it is good or bad?
Bad.
Because if somebody sells at what? Lower price, what happens to my demand?
Falls.
When the demand falls, what happens?
Cost per unit increases.
So what happens?
Profit increases.
What happens? Selling price increases. Further triggers what?
Demand drop and so on.
After some time, product will be pushed out of the market. In this case, the formula is wrong. It is not selling price is equal to cost plus profit. Change as what?
Target cost is equal to selling price minus profit.
So LHS, RHS rearranged. What happened? Not only LHS, RHS rearranged. The conception is what?
Change.
That is how you understand. Perception is what?
Change.
So in this case, we earlier said that I am fixing selling price. Now I believe that what?
Selling price is market demand.
Here I say, I don't have a control over cost. Here I say what? I should achieve the target cost. Cost is within my control. The question is, I am manufacturing currently at 988. I want to make it as what?
82.
How can I reduce my cost? But no of the say no input cost is what in my hand. I can reduce my cost by improving my efficiency through the process called as what?
Value engineering.
Has got two aspects, namely design and process engineering. What is the design of a product?
Bundle of features.
The features can be of functional, aesthetic. Functional defines a utility. Aesthetic adds a appeal to the product. Aesthetic can be value added, non-value added. Functionality is always what?
Value added.
Once I eliminate the non-value added features, the activity related to those features can be avoided. When activities are avoided, activity based cost can be what?
Saved.
How much the cost can be saved can be understood only when I have what? An ABC system with a prerequisites for a target costing system. Respond. Yes or no?
No.
Process is a way of doing things. Okay, it can be a production process or a selling process, anything. Have a close look at the process and find out what are the unwanted movements, activities which I am doing. Eliminate unwanted activity, non-valued activity. I'll be saving the activity based cost, thereby achieving the target cost. So no. Still, after doing all this, if you're not able to achieve the target cost, next option is what?
Compromise on margin.
Still you're not able to achieve means what?
Quit the market
rather than being what? Sent out of the market is the essence of the target costing system. Everybody understanding or not? Can I start with the problem?
No.
Okay, see, I have divided this chapter into three segments. Section 1 is activity based costing. It is a much more serious chapter, lot of calculations are involved. Section 2 is what? Section 2 is target costing. Section 2 is target costing. And section 3 is target costing with what? Activity based costing. These are the three sections. I given some additional problem which are past examination questions from this particular area. Everybody following on? Including some applied theory has been discussed. We'll be seeing that in the later stages. Can I start or not?
No.
This chapter alone, I want to do it elaborately because very regularly asking the examination. No need to push through this particular chapter. Target and then what?
ABC.
Can you start or not?
No.
Only thing is, I want to have sufficient time. Please cooperate. Can you start or not?
No.
Take question number 8. This question is more theory based with help of number. Okay, it gives you the entire introduction to target costing. Remaining problems are all some interesting questions which applies the target costing concepts. Okay, now. For many years, Lenovo Corporation has used a straightforward cost plus pricing system. Has used a straightforward cost plus pricing system, marking its product, marking its goods up approximately 25% on total cost. The company has been profitable. However, it has recently lost considerable business to foreign competitors that have become very aggressive in the marketplace. An example of Lenovo's problem is typified by item number 8976, which has the following unit cost characteristics. Material 30, labor 75, overheads 50, selling expenses is 25. If I total what the current manufacturing cost, 105, 155, 180. So the current cost is 180. The going market price of an identical product comparable quality is 195, which is significantly below what Lenovo is charging. Calculate cost plus pricing, contrast cost plus pricing and target costing. Which of the two approaches could be aptly labeled as price-led costing? Why? What is Lenovo's current selling price of item number 8976? If Lenovo used target costing for the item number 8976, what must happen to the cost if the company decides to meet the market price and maintain its current rate of profit on sales? By how much? Would the identification of value-added and non-value-added cost assist Lenovo in the situation? Briefly explain. Suppose that the previous cost-cutting drives costs have already been pared to the bone on item 8976. What might Lenovo be forced to do with its markup on cost to remain competitive, and by how much is the question? Can we start or not? No. Nothing great. What I have discussed only is asked as different questions. That's all. When I write the answer for this, I given you the full notes for what? Target costing itself. More intricacies will be discussed along with the ABC later. Everybody, can I start or not? No. First, write down. Give the heading target costing. Question number 8. Question number 8. We'll do it together the problem. Okay, question number 8. Don't think it, no introduction is given. The introduction is given with this particular problem. Can I proceed? Question number 8. Step 1. Calculation of. We need not answer in the same order, but all questions will be ultimately answered. Okay, step 1. Calculation of Lenovo's current selling price. Calculation of Lenovo's current selling price. Calculation of Lenovo's current selling price. Can I start or not? No. Particulars amount. Two columns. Particulars amount. First write. Product cost. Don't think product cost, period cost. The cost of the product. Okay. Product cost. You know, you may get that confusion. So product cost. Well, product cost 180. Product cost 180. Add markup. Add markup. Lenovo adds how much percent? 25%. Add markup at 25%. What is 25% of 180? 45. Selling price. What is selling price? 225. Selling price 225. Can I proceed or not? Now, step 2. Target cost. Step 2. Target cost. Can I push it on? No. Tell me, is a 225 correct selling price or a wrong selling price? Wrong. Because all the competitors are selling at what? 195 and so on. If you sell at 225, the demand what? Drops. If you continue to follow this cost plus pricing, what happens? The cost increases. What happens selling price? Increases. further triggers a demand up and so on. It becomes a vicious cycle and the product will be pushed out of the market. Respond, yes or no? No. In the step number two, right? Point number one. In the right point number one. If Leno adopts cost plus pricing, if Leno adopts cost plus pricing and sells the product at 225, if Leno adopts cost plus pricing and sells the product at 225, the following things happens. The following things happens. The following things happen. Can I proceed? In the right? A. The demand reduces. In point one, in the right what? A. The demand reduces because of higher price. The demand reduces because of higher price. Point B. The unit cost increases. The unit cost increases because the unit cost increases because why the per unit cost increases? Because what? The same fixed cost is shared by the unit cost increases because the same fixed cost is shared by fewer units. Because the same fixed cost is shared by fewer units. The same fixed cost is shared by fewer units. Point C. When the unit cost increases, what happens? The selling price increases. You need not worry about profit. I merge with selling price. Okay, the selling price increases. The selling price increases due to cost plus pricing. The selling price increases due to cost plus pricing. The selling price increases due to cost plus pricing. Point C or D, which further triggers. Sorry, which further triggers, it further triggers what? Demand drop. Which further triggers demand drop and this becomes what? Vicious cycle. And this becomes vicious cycle. Vicious cycle means what? It is a cycle that is bad. Okay, the word vicious means what? Bad. It becomes a bad cycle. It becomes vicious cycle. Point C or D. Point number? What do you want here? Okay, point E. Please, don't disturb. Point E, please. After some time, the product will be pushed out of the market. After some time, the product will be pushed out of the market. After some time, the product will be pushed out of the market. The product will be pushed out of the market. Everybody, are you following this point number one or not? So now point number one is elaborating what? The problem regarding the cost plus pricing. Yes or no? Now, next point number two. Same step two we are doing, point number two. An alternative is to go for what? Target costing. An alternative is to go for target costing where the equation becomes. Alternative is to go for target costing where the equation becomes. The equation becomes what? Target cost is equal to. Where the equation becomes target cost is equal to what minus what? Selling price minus profit. Target cost is equal to selling price minus profit. Point two or three? Three. This is not change in equation. This is not change in equation, but the change in attitude. It is not change in equation, but the change in attitude. It is not the change in equation, but the change in attitude. Target costing recognizes that. Continue. Target costing recognizes that selling prices. Target costing recognizes that selling prices market determined. Selling price is market determined. And company has no control over it. Selling price is market determined. And company has no control over it. And company has no control over it. You don't say I fix selling price, you may fix that will be sent out, yes or no? So it is going to be what? Market determined, and the company has no control over it. But what can be really controlled is, what? Cost. What can be really controlled is cost. What can be really controlled is what? Cost. Point number four or five? Point number four. Cost plus pricing is cost-led pricing. What leads to selling price? Your cost. Okay, cost plus pricing is what? Cost-led pricing. LED. Cost-led pricing. But target costing is, what is target? Target is what? Price-led costing. Target costing is price-led costing. Do you understand or not? Earlier it was cost that leads to what? Selling price. Now it is the price that leads to what? The target cost. Target costing is what? Price-led costing. Last point. Point number five. Market determined price is equal to, we are doing the calculation. Market determined price is equal to, look at the workbook and tell me, what is the number? 195. Market determined price is equal to 195. Minus desired markup. Right? Minus desired markup. Be careful. I want 25% on cost. Kadaba. Yeah, correct. I want 25% on cost. How much will be on selling price here? 20%. Yes or no? Yes or no? 25 by 125 is what? 1/5 on selling price. So minus markup at 20%. Minus markup at 20%. Tell me, what is 195 into 20%? 39. Minus desired markup, 39 at 20%. Tell me, what is the target cost? Target cost is 156. Target cost is 156. Everybody understanding or not? Now, step number two over. What is step number two? Fixing the target cost. Okay. I should sell at 190. Father, I should manufacture and sell in the house. Sell at how much rupees here? 156. Can I pass it? Step three. Value engineering. Okay, in that right, point number one. The company should try to reduce the current cost of 180 to, how much rupees? 156. The company should try to reduce the current cost of 180 to 156. The target cost reduction is 24 rupees. Can I understand or not? Now, point number two. To do this, it should start a value engineering program. Continue, same point. You write VE from now onwards in the classroom. Okay, value engineering is what? VE, right? Okay, Value engineering is a process through which the costs are classified as what? The costs are classified as value added and non-value added. one exam question, they gave you four items and say whether it is value added or non-value added. The question also is there in the workbook. Therefore, 5 marks, 4 seconds. So what I am saying, next. The process is the cost of classified as value added and
non-value added.
Next, point number three. Point number three. Value engineering process has two aspects. Value engineering process has two aspects. Has two aspects. Branched into two. Branched into two. First branch, design engineering. First branch is design engineering. Second is what? Process engineering. Design engineering and then process engineering. Design engineering, put that down if I can write. A design of a product. In design engineering, put it down if I can write. A design of a product is nothing but. A design of a product is nothing but bundle of features. A design of a product is nothing but bundle of features which can be classified into two. A design of a product is nothing but bundle of features which can be classified into two. Branch it into two. Which can be classified into two, branched into two. All this we are discussing in the first branch. Are you following? Branched into two. In that first branch, functional features. Second branch, aesthetic features. Ayyappa. Aesthetic. Abdi nanakire. Okay, you can just. Go and do the spell check later. Functional features, aesthetic features. I think it is right. I don't know. Okay. Yes. Edia. Aesthetic features. Now, I will turn the page. Should not record. Okay. Now, aesthetic features. Okay. Now, Edia Chaba. Okay. Go and check. Okay. Functional features, aesthetic features. Rupash. Functional features. Put the down your mark and write. Functional features, put that down again, right?
Excellent.
Define the utility of the product. Define the utility of the product. Functional features, right? Define utility of the product. And is always value added. Functional features, right? Defines utility of the product and is always value added. Aesthetic features, put the down mark and write, adds appeal to the product. Aesthetic features, right? Adds appeal to the product. And is value added only when customer is willing to pay for it. And is value added only when customer is willing to pay for it. Everybody understanding it or not? Now go to the second branch. The second branch is what? Process engineering. Put a domain and write. Once design is finalized, analyze the production and selling process. Analyze the production and selling process and eliminate the non-value added process. This can be done. Can you write? This can be done when the company continuously seeks to. This can be done when the company continuously seeks to improve its process. This can be done when the company continuously seeks to improve its process, which is called K Kaizen approach. K-A-I-Z-E-N, which is called Kaizen approach. K-A-I-Z-E-N, which is called what? Kaizen approach. K-A-I-Z-E-N. You call us what? Kaizen approach. Please. Shh. Can I push it out? Now, last point. Point number three or four. When non-value added features. When non-value added features are eliminated. The activities required, to have those features can be avoided. The activity required to have those features can be avoided. Thereby saving activity-based costs. To know how much is saved, we require. What system? ABC system. Same for process engineering also. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Now, point number four or five? Even after value engineering, After the cost is pared to the bone, P-A-R-E-D, the cost is pared to the bone. Illa phrases use. Pared to the bone, na, very simple, yeah. I'm very fat. I want to lose unnecessary kilos. What I can do? I can do exercise and reduce it. Either value engineering. Kadaba. Non-value added fat can be what? Reduce. Kadaba. Now. Like this pad to board, no more fat. Yes or no? In that case, everything non-value has been what? Reduced. I'm now very slim. Yes or no? Still, I cannot meet target weight. What I can do? Can I cut the organ and all? Yes or no? No. What I can do? I have to compromise on what? Margin. That is, I come to the product, I have to compromise on what? Margin. Write down. Next. Even after value engineering, that is, cost is pared to the bone. Still target cost not achieved, then the company has to compromise on margin. Even after that, if target cost could not be achieved, the company should quit the market. But never should it increase selling price. Otherwise, it will be pushed out of the market. otherwise it will be pushed out of the market. With this we have completed through this problem the elaborate notes and introduction to chapter called as what? Target costing. Okay, now take question number 10. With this we'll complete the today's class. Take question number 10. Okay, please. A live example of how the design engineering can be done by a company. Okay, please take question number 10. Stop talking, please. Shall I start up? No. Danish furniture manufacturers, please. Danish furniture manufactures easy to assemble wooden furniture for home and office. The firm is considering modification of a table to make it more attractive to individuals and businesses. The table is small, can be used to hold a computer printer or a fax machine, and has several shelves for storage. Please. The company's marketing department surveyed potential buyers of the table regarding the 5 proposed modifications. 200 survey participants were asked to evaluate the modifications by using a 5-point scale. Okay, 5-point scale, POINT, by using a 5-point scale. Do you know where I am reading? Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, 5-point scale. Okay, now. That range from 1 strongly disagree to 5 strongly agree. Their responses along DF's related unit costs for the modifications are as follows. Modification 1, add cabinet doors to the storage. It costs 6 rupees for that feature. 10 out of 200 strongly disagree. 20 out of 200 disagreed. 30 is neutral, 60 agreed, 80 strongly recommended it. Expand the storage area of the table. It costs 2.5 rupees to have that feature. 10, 40, 70, 50, 30 strongly disagreed, disagreed, neutral, agree and strongly agree respectively. Add security lock to the storage area, 1.65 cost. The frequency is given. Like that the modifications are given. Table currently costs 64 to produce and distribute, and DP selling price for this unit averages 80. Current selling price for these tables with all or some of the aforesaid features averages 95. Required, why there is a need in target costing to A, focus on customer, B, have a marketing team become involved with the product design. DF's marketing team will evaluate the survey responses by computing a weighted average rating of each of the modification. This will be accomplished by weighing or multiplying the point values 1, 2, etc. by the frequency of responses, summing the results and dividing by 200. Simply weighted average. Can you see? Now, rank the popularity of the 5 modifications using this approach. 3. Management decides to earn approximately the same rate of profit on the sales that is being earned with the current design. A. If DF uses target costing and decides to meet the current competitive selling price, what is the maximum cost of modified table? Which modification should DF consider? Assume that DF wanted to add a modification or two. You excluded in your answer to 3B. What process might management adopt to allow company to make its target profit for the table? Briefly explain is a question. A good problem that explains in summary the target costing process. Again, the problem is from Hongren and it's a good problem. These are all chapters having only limited problems in the various books. If at all the institute will ask what? The same problem in this regard. Okay, now just go through the question. I think there's no need to go through the question. Start with what? Solution. Anyhow, I thought value added time, non-value added time. Anyhow, you are not going to what?
Read it.
I'll explain and posi. Can I posi? Now. Now. Question can be understood with some calculation first. Can I start or not? Now. Let's start with some calculations and then explain the question as it progresses. It is a very simple question to answer. But we'll see how really in the market target costing system works. Can you understand or not? Now, write on first. Step one. Step one. Calculation of the desired profit margin for DF. Please. We'll do it together. Step one, calculation of the desired profit margin for DF. Calculation of the desired profit margin for DF. And like that. DF is a company, Danish Furniture. Okay. Calculation of desired profit margin for DF. And like that. Can you start or not? No. Currently, they are selling at how much rupees? 80 rupees. Having a cost of what? 64. Right on. First. Current selling price is equal to, write down, current selling price is equal to 80. It is given in the first paragraph below the table. Current selling price is equal to 80. Minus cost is equal to how much rupees? 64. Minus cost is equal to 64. Profit is equal to 16. Right, percentage profit on selling price is equal to, percentage profit on selling price is equal to 16/80 × 100. Percentage profit on selling price is equal to 16/80 × 100. How much percent? 20%. That is the desired margin is equal to 20%. Next line, percentage profit on cost is equal to 16/64. Percentage profit on cost is equal to 16/64 × 100. Is equal to how much? 25%. So the company decides to earn 20% on selling price or 25% on what? Cost is the current requirement of the company. Right or not? Next. Step 2. Calculation of target cost of modified table. Calculation of target cost of modified table. Okay. Market determines selling price. Look at the workbook and tell me the table is sold in the market. How much rupees? 95. Market determines selling price 95. Minus desired margin at 20%. Market determines selling price 95 minus desired margin at 20%. I want more than 20% selling price or not? Minus desired margin at 20%. What is the desired margin at 20%? 19. How many rupees here? 19. It is 19. Target cost of modified table. What is 95 minus 19? 76. Target cost of modified table 76. Now stop writing. From here I'll explain the question, what it is all about, and then complete the solution in no time. Can you start or not? Now see, stop talking. Presently this company is selling a table. Now they want to modify it with more features. Modify it with what? More features. Five features are provided. What are the five features? Cabinet doors. The table can be having a cabinet door for the storage area. Can have a expanded storage area. Can have a security lock. And we can give what? A rich appearance by having a marble top. Yes or no? And we can give a more warranty for the table by giving a guarantee for more number of years. Yes or no? No. Please. These are all the features I can add to the table. Respond. Yes or no? No. with these features, all or some of them, in the market, the modified table is selling how much rupees? Yeah, 95 rupees. Everybody understood or not? No. Now, the question is, presently without modification, I am spending 64. Right? With a decent margin, a modified table can be spending maximum rupees, 76. That means I can afford to say spend 12 rupees towards the 5 modification. How much I can afford to spend for the modification? 12 rupees is what I can afford to spend. That's what, yes or no? No. If I want to add all the 5 modification, add it, cabinet door cost me 6, expenditure is going to be how much? 2.5 gives you 8.5, plus what? 1.6 gives you what? 10.15, plus what? 4.25, plus what? 5.1. Obviously crosses what? 12 rupees. That means one thing is sure, I cannot add all the modification on my table because it does not meet my target cost. Yes or no? No. That means we are sure about one thing. I cannot add all the 5 modification. Only some of them can be added. And some should be what? Left out. Yes or no? What should be added or left out is the desire of the management or customer. You are producing for the customer, not for your enjoyment. Yes or no? In that case, I should produce for what? Customer. I should know which modification customer likes the most, which he does not like it. So I have to go for a survey. Yes or no? So the company conducted a survey of how many customers? 200 customers and got their responses. Everybody yes or no? They asked them to rank the modification or give the points to modification in the scale of 1 to 5. Yes or no? If they give 5, they are going to like the modification very much. If they give what? 1, they totally disagree. Yes or no? For example, say security lock, take a modification. Out of 200, 30 what? Strongly disagree. He may be thief. He strongly what? Disagree. Okay. Now, out of what? Next 60 is what? Disagreeing. Maybe beggar because does not keep anything to have. Yes or no? No. Does not have anything to keep. Okay. Neutral is what? 50. 40 what? Agree. And 20 what? Strongly agree. Like that. I took responses from what? 200 customers. Like that they gave the point. Everybody yes or no? No. See. Like a limiting factor, I have told rupees. What I should do first is, I should find out the weighted point. Find out what point there? Weighted point. That is 10 by 200 into 1. Whatever. For example, cabinet door, 10 out of 200 what? Gave 1 point. 20 by 200 into what? 2. 30 by 200 into what? 3. And so on. If I add it, I get the weighted point for cabinet door. Yes or no? Suppose everybody said agree, na, the point is what? 5. Every disagree means what? Point is one. Some agreed, some disagreed, and so on. In that case, I find out the weighted average point for all the 5 and rank them on the descending order of what? Points. Highest point should be given what? First rank. Lowest should be given what? Last rank. And allocate the 12 rupees in order of what? Ranking is the solution to this problem first. Everybody following on what? It really sees how the target costing process works, where you conduct a customer survey, get their responses, and then do the design engineering, and then go for the marketing. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? No. Shall we proceed further or not? No. After what you have done here? Calculation of? Target cost. Now, step number 2 or 3? 3. Step number 3. Step number 3. Ranking the modification based on customer preferences. 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 Underline that. Right, point number 1. Current cost is 64. Current cost is 64. We should lead to the solution, na? Give the background. Current cost is 64 and target cost is 76. Current cost is 64 and the target cost is 76. Hence, the company can maximum spend. Hence, the company can maximum spend how much rupees? 12 rupees towards modification. Hence, the company can maximum spend 12 rupees towards modification. The company can maximum spend ₹12 towards modification. Point number 2. It is not possible to have all modifications within ₹12. It is not possible to have all modifications within ₹12. It is not possible to have all modifications within ₹12. Hence, only some of them can be added. Hence, only some of them can be added. Point number 2 or 3? 3. What should be selected? What should be selected depends on the customer preferences. What should be selected depends on the customer preferences. Depends on the customer preferences obtained through a survey of 200 customers. Obtained through a survey of 200 customers. Everybody understanding or not? Next. Point number 3 or 4? 4. Ranking the customer preferences based on weights. Ranking the customer preferences based on weights. Ranking customer preferences based on weights. Okay. Have the following columns based on weights. WEIGHTS based on weights. Have the following columns. Modification. A very broad column, computation. Next column, weighted point. Last column, rank. Modification, computation, weighted point, rank. Weighted point, rank can be small columns, will not cross 2 decimals. And the computation should be broad one, modification, medium size. Okay. Modification, computation, weighted points, and then rank. Can I proceed it now? Can I start or not? Now, right, one by one. What the first modification? Tell me. What first item? Cabinet doors. First modification is cabinet doors. Now, the question gave you how to do it. We also know how to do it. Very simple. How to do it? Yeah. 10 into 1 plus 20 into 2 plus 30 into 3 plus 60 into 4 plus 80 into 5. Whole divided by what? 200. In a 10 plus 20 plus 30 plus 60 plus 80 is what? 200. Very simple. Weighted average. W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X3 plus W4 X4 plus W5 X5 whole divided by what? W1 plus W plus W3 gives you what? The 200 denominator. Respond. It's all known now. Write the computation. First, write down 10 into 1 plus what? 20 into 2 10 into 1 plus 20 into 2 plus 30 into 3 plus 60 into 4 plus 80 into 5 divided by 200. 18 to 5 divided by 200. Whole divided by 200. Tell me the weighted point, please. 3.9. The weighted point is 3.9. The weighted point is 3.9. And write it here. It's going to be 3.9. Next. Storage area. 10 into 1 plus 40 into 2 plus 70 into 3 plus 50 into 4 plus 30 into 5. Whole divided by 200. Okay, tell me what is the number here? 3.25. The weighted point is 3.25. Next, security lock. 30 into 1 plus 60 into 2 plus 50 into 3 plus 40 into 4 plus 20 into 5. whole divided by 200. Whole divided by, what is the number? 2.8. Number is 2.8. 10 into 1 plus. Oh, heading, okay. Rich appearance. Heading is what? Rich appearance. Rich appearance. 10 into 1 plus. 20 into 2 plus. 50 into 3 plus. 60 into 4 plus. 60 into 5. Whole divided by 200. What's the number? 3.7. It is 3.7. Extended warranty. Extended warranty. 40 into 1 plus. 70 into 2 plus. 30, please. 30 into 3 plus. 35 into 4 plus. 25 into 5 whole divided by 200. What's the number? 2.67. So calculator, scan for virus. Can I say 2.67? Can I say or not? Now, next. Go for rank. Go for rank. Please. Please stop talking. Go for rank. Now, overall responses, if you see, the general public first likes what feature? Cabinet door. It should be given the first rank. Okay. Second rank should be given to rich appearance. Second rank should be given to rich appearance. Please. Third rank should be given to storage area. Fourth rank should be given to what? Security lock. And the last should be given to warranty. Extended warranty. These are the ranks given for the modification. Respond is so known. I should start allocating money in the order of what? Ranks. Within the 12. It's a limiting factor allocation. Right or not? Right on. Next. What a heading given for this? The main heading. Step number 3. Please. Now, step number 3, what heading given? Rank modification. Right on. Step number 4. Selection of modification within available rupees 12 cost. Selection of modification within available rupees 12 cost. Within available rupees 12 cost. Have the following columns. Modification with available rupees 12 cost. Have the following columns. Modification. Second column is cost. Third column is sigma cost. Modification, cost, and then sigma cost. Given the order of the ranking. First is what? First is cabinet doors. For that feature, what the cost? What the cost here? 6. 3 point is a weighted point. I want the cost. What the cost here? 6. What the cost spent till now? 6. Second rank is what? Rich appearance. Second modification is rich appearance. For that feature, what are the cost? 4.25. What is sigma cost? 10.25. Sigma cost is 10.25. Third is what? Storage area. What are the cost? 2.5. Can I add it or no? Because I have only how much rupees here? 12 rupees. So right, not possible. So, the third rank cannot be done because it requires 2.5. I don't have such money. So, no. Now, next is what? Security lock. Security lock. What is the amount? 1.65. What is the sigma? 11.9. 11.9. For 10 paise, no feature. So, no. Now, I spend how much rupees here? 11.9. Can I put it or not? Write down. Next. The company should select, the company should select the following features. The company should select the following features, namely the company should select the following features, namely cabinet doors, rich appearance and security lock. Now, see, if they want to add all the five features, want to add all the five features, what features are left out? Please tell me what features are left out. Storage area for 2.5 and warranty by how much? 5.1. These two together require how much? 7.6. Enappa right or not? No. I don't have the money for it, yes or no? No. What I can do is, I can try to go for value engineering, try to reduce the current 64 rupees cost. So go for a cost reduction, I'll be getting what? More space, to add what? More features, yes or no? That means, what should be my target cost reduction now? I should go for value engineering to reduce my cost by 2.5 plus 5 gives you what? 7.6. True or false? Yes. See, I cannot add all the five features. I added only what? 3. I left out 2 because it is not within my budget of 12 rupees. Yes, why? The target cost is what? 76. Suppose I want to have all the five features. Can I have an increased selling price? No. What I should do? I should try to reduce the current cost of 64 to some number below. Yes or no? So that will be having what? More amount spendable towards what? Modification. So now the question is, how much should be the target cost reduction? Tell me, how much should be here? 2.5 plus what? 5.1 gives you what? 7.6 is a requirement, no? So should I reduce the cost by 7.6? No. Only 10 paise available there. Got it? I spent only 11.9. I have 10 paise in that margin or not? In that case, I should go for cost reduction of the tune of what? 7.5. That is going to be the next target. Yes or no? Right now, next step. Step 4 of 5. Step 5. Strategy to include all features. Unline that. Can I put or not? In the drive. To include the remaining two features. Point number one, to include the remaining two features, we need to spend 7.6. But we already have 0.1 cushion. Because 12 rupees allowed to spend, I spend only what? 11.9. We already have 0.1 cushion. And needs to reduce cost by, how much rupees? 7.5. Point number 2. This can be done by value engineering. See previous page. Don't write an examination, I'll write a value engineering fully. Okay, see previous page. Yes or no? I cannot dictate it again and again. See what? Previous page. Bracket close. Okay, point number 2 or 3? 3. Still, if target cost reduction not achieved, what should I do? Compromise on margin. Never should selling price be increased. This is the answer for this particular question. Everybody following or not? Now, 1 minute. Part 1 is a theory question. I will tell, you can write on your own. Okay, very simple only. Why is there a need in target costing to focus on what? Customer and have a marketing team involved in it. Now, see, target costing is a multidisciplinary function. Okay, please. Stop here. To have a For this, what should be the production flow, what type of machines should be invested, will be given by what? Process engineer, plan, layout, etc. Anything written or not? No. Cost accountant only will be able to contribute heavily regarding what? What cost can be saved by eliminating some features. He gives an ABC information. Yes or no? Why CFO is required? I have a profit margin. Na? Profit margin should be at least giving me an IRR more than cost of capital. Yes or no? So I'll compromise some profit margin. 1 rupee profit enough. It may result in what? Yeah, IRR less than what? Cost of capital. Negative NPV project. So no. In that case, I require my funding cost etc. to be understood before I fix the profit margin. So no. And board will take what? Finally, the strategic decision whether they want to penetrate, compromising and what? Everything. Or they want to play safe. All this will be decided by what? Board of directors. Who is the ultimate deciding authority? So no. All these persons are involved in a target costing system. Everybody following what I'm saying? Now, role la purinjapa. Now, tell me, what are the persons here? Marketing. Engineer. That is, design engineer. Process engineer. The cost accountant, don't call cost accountant, call us what? Management accountant, right name. Next is what? The CFO, and finally what? The board, all are involved. Marketing team to know the customer preference, the designer to know what? The features, how to be added, process to know what? The layout, etc. And for cost accountant to give what? ABC information, and the CFO to know the profit margin that should be surely earned on the capital employed, and finally what? The board to make the strategic decision. Everybody is so known. Yeah. With this, that is the first part of the question. Can you answer that or not? No. With this, we complete the question number 10 in this chapter. Next class, we'll continue and complete target costing. Also start doing the ABC.